Learn how to get started with natural language understanding in Azure in this episode of Azure Tips and Tricks. The Natural Language service in Azure enables users to interact with your app using natural language. Let's try it out. First, I need to create a language understanding resource in Azure. There it is. And create. All right. First, I'll leave this to both. This lets you choose to create a language understanding resource for only the creation of the model or only for the prediction service part or both. Okay, now select a resource group. And now I'll put in a name, like this. And also for the authoring service. This is the part of the service that lets you create a model and train it. Okay. And the prediction resource is the REST API that you can use in your app. This can be in a different location than the authoring resource. All right, let's create it. And I'll skip to when it is done. Here we go. This is the authoring resource. And here in the Quick Start blade, I can use this URL to open the language understanding portal. Okay, that's it. First, let's start by creating an app. All right, I'll give it a name. And now I'll select a prediction resource. And that's it. Okay, here we go. This is the app. And in here, I can create a language model that can understand what users are saying. Instead of building one from scratch, I can pick a pre-built domain from here. These are language models for scenarios like home automation, planning, and this one for weather. Let's add it. Okay. The main components of a language understanding application are intents and entities. Intents, like these, are how the language understanding service understands what users want to do. Intents are made up of utterances, which are examples of what a user could input, like these. And these utterances contain entities, like this weather range, or this one, that identifies words that represent a time. Let's see. These are the entities that are used in the model. There are pre-built entities, like the datetime v2, which, when it is inserted in an utterance, detects dates, days, months, and other date-related words, and then translates that into information that your app can use. There are also custom entities, which you can create yourself. You can create entities that detect certain words in a list, like east, west, or south, and entities that are machine-learned. The machine-learned entities learn their possible values from example utterances. So, intents and entities make up the model. And here in the settings, I can tweak the behavior of the model and its machine learning training. All right, now we need to train the model. Here it goes. It now uses machine learning to create a model that can predict what user input means. Okay, it's done. Let's test it. And here we go. I'll type something that a user might type in. Okay. It spits out a result, which I can inspect. All right. So the service predicts that the intent of this input was weather.checkWeatherTime, and it predicts that with a 99% certainty. It also detected the weather.weatherRange entity from the word hottest and the historic entity from the word month. Pretty cool. Now, let's publish this model to an API endpoint. Here, you'd use a staging slot to test the API endpoint that it produces, and if that works as expected, promote it to the production slot. You can also indicate if you want to use sentiment analysis to evaluate the sentiment of text input, apply Bing spell check to compensate for spelling errors, and speech priming to improve the recognition of spoken words and phrases that are commonly used in your app. These additional options use Azure Cognitive Services to enhance the language understanding service. All right, here we go. Let's deploy it. So now I can find the URL to the endpoint of the published API. Let's copy that. And let's open a browser and try to use the API. At the end of the query here, I can type in the user input, like this. All right, let's see. That's it. This is the same result as we saw in the test window, but now as JSON data, which you can use in your app. The language understanding service can help you to interact with your users by understanding what they are saying. Go and check it out.